and salutations to anyone out there able to receive this little broadcast of mine. Once again, it is I, yours truly, the resident hermit of this once frozen water region, since turned humid rainforest, located in the southernmost region of my beloved homeworld, planet Earth. And you heard me right. In case you are not from this planet, you see, many millennia ago, long before I ever came into existence, a cataclysmic event of global proportion caused the Earth's, this planet's, north and south poles to switch to east and west. But I'm not here to bore you with tales from the long distant past. However, if you are ever interested in giving little old me a visit, well, my coordinates are 70.996269 degrees south and 146.685521 degrees west. You will find me, the only humanoid living on this rainforest island, in an old wartime bunker. You can't miss it. There are still 4 nuclear missiles poised to launch right outside. But don't worry, I've taken upon myself to make sure they can never be launched. When I first discovered this bunker, I made sure to disconnect and dismantle any type of armaments and such, but, well, most of it, I should say, nature took care of most of that for me in the millennia that has passed since the event and all the chaos that ensued afterwards. But enough about me and why I'm here. Let's talk about you. Who are you, anyway? And what are you doing right now? Why don't you and I play a little game where I try to guess what it is that you're currently up to? Maybe you are out in the far reaches of space, piloting a vulture, orca, or federal corvette, as you engage your frameshift drive to jump through hyperspace from one star system to another. Perhaps you are an Argonian, a Nord, or even a Khajiit, who is on a very important quest. Out in the wild land known as Skyrim. Maybe you are out scavenging for parts or investigating an abandoned vault or even assisting yet another settlement that needs your help out in the ever so dangerous wasteland that was once known as the United States of America, right here on my home planet. Maybe you are living in a small community in a world overrun with the dead, often referred to as walkers, and the leader of your particular group just so happens to be a barbed-wired baseball bat-wielding psychopath named Negan. Just maybe. Perhaps you are a secret agent on an even more secret mission to assassinate a target using nothing more than an explosive rubber ducky. Maybe you are a researcher, scientist, working for a clandestine organization that is in charge of keeping various anomalies in containment. Maybe you are currently hiding in a locker, trying to avoid being caught by a killer that might use shock therapy, hatchets, as a deformed young twin, or uses various traps to kill survivors in a strange, twisted realm that you can never truly escape from. Perhaps you are indeed hiding in a locker, but on a spaceship, one that is infested with xenomorphs. Perhaps you are happily mining for emeralds or diamonds in caves far beneath the surface that are infested with skeletons, spiders, and the ever-dangerous creepers. Maybe you are currently enjoying your favorite beverage and meal at the restaurant at the end of the universe, or I should say one of the universes in this never-ending multiverse. Or lastly, perhaps just maybe, you are buried up to your neck in a place called Margaret's Garden, which just so happens to be located on the premises of one Arkham Sanitarium for mental rehabilitation. Well, my friend and friends, whatever the case may be, whoever you are, wherever you are, however you are, whenever you are, whichever you are, and why ever you are, one thing is constant, and that is ever prevalent stress and anxiety. And the only way to battle those arch enemies of ours is with peace of mind. And that, my friends, is exactly why I'm here. As you know, unless you happen to be tuning in for the first time, I make it my business to travel across the lands, whether a jungle, a desert, or a mountain, in search of all manners of what we would now call ancient artifacts, in order to bring them here and to share with you what I found, with the hope that it will help you to relax. So, my friends, what do you say we get started with this month's finds? Perhaps you'll find them interesting as I provide what information I could dig up, no pun intended, on them, as well as try to manipulate them to make some very pleasing sounds, and hopefully the sounds will transmit well across the airwaves, whether you're listening here on my home world, or whether you are out some distant place in a whole other universe altogether. And I would love to hear from you if there is any way for you to somehow contact me. You can leave a little message somewhere and let me know what it is that you're currently involved with and where you are as you listen to this little transmission of mine, little broadcast. Okay, I think I've spoken long enough. Why don't we get down to business, my friend? First thing I have is what was once known as a video game controller. It's quite hard to describe, but it's almost like the controls of a spaceship, just without it being attached to anything. It's about 6 to 8 inches wide. It has two joysticks, which you would use to move a character around on a screen, and buttons to interact with the video game and the character. So, allow me just a moment. I'm going to make some sounds with this, but first I need to tie down the receiver of my microphone so I can talk hands-free. Okay, that should do it. So what you should be hearing now are all of the clicking sounds of the controller as I press the different buttons. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 buttons and two joysticks. And, well, I guess you would say my ancestors would play video games for hours upon hours. All manners of video games, too. Fighting video games. We would fight different opponents, whether virtual or controlled by other humans. Adventure video games where you would go on quests. Story-driven video games. Puzzle video games. Simulations where you could pretend you were a farmer or in charge of civilization. So many types of video games. Some of the ones I can remember vaguely when I first discovered this object. This video game controller. Some of the video games were titled Pac-Man, Donkey Kong, Assassin's Creed, Hitman, Call of Duty. I believe was based on real events. Dead by Daylight. And so many others. I wish I could have lived back in that time. Sure would have been a lot of fun to escape from the... oh, from the struggles, I guess, of existing in this day and age. See what else I have for you, my friends. What you are listening to now is the sound of what was once called plastic wrap. This object, or this material, was a thin sheet of plastic. It was transparent, and people would use cut away sections of this plastic sheet. It was very thin. Sticky, but there was no sticky adhesive material on it. And they would use this plastic wrap to wrap up their food items to keep them fresh. Last a little bit longer, and they would store these plastic wrapped food items in their refrigerators. These refrigerators were 5 foot tall rectangular boxes. Made of metal on the outside, plastic on the inside, and were refrigerated, just as the name implies. And they would run off of an energy source known as electricity. Of food and beverage, and they even had a section called a freezer where you could freeze your food. Friends, is plastic wrap. You were listening to a sheet of that material that was balled up into a little wad of crinkly plastic. I find that to be quite a soothing sound. How about you? This next item I have is actually a tool. It is a screwdriver of sorts, oblong, made of metal. It has a wood handle. And right in the middle, the extended arm or the tool itself, the long metal shaft that ends in a screwdriver, flat screwdriver. Makes this very pleasant clicking sound. Found this quite useful myself. Doing minor repairs here and there. Okay, my friends, I hope you enjoyed that. Next up, I have these plastic square containers, these cases. These were once called CD cases, and in them are flat discs, about six, seven. circumference or diameter. Well, yours truly isn't a math wizard, but... And people would use these discs and insert them into portable radios so they could listen to their music on the go as they traveled. And even their motor vehicles, their cars, their trucks would have what was called CD players, where you could insert these discs and listen to music as you drove your vehicle. And I have such artists here, just a sample. One is called Static X. Another is called Rage Against the Machine. Another is Experience Hendrix, the best of Jimi Hendrix, who I believe at one time was a pretty good drummer, if I'm not mistaken. Such songs as Purple Haze, Fire, The Wind Cries Mary, Hey Joe, All Along the Watchtower, Foxy Lady, so on. And lastly, another band called Alice in Chains. So I thought I would just tap on the case. Music used to be a big part of various cultures and pastimes here on this planet. So many different types of music. Listen to music on these CDs, but also would pay to go see their favorite artist, musician, play for thousands of people who would gather around either on a field or in these large structures called stadiums. Okay, let's see what I have for you next. hope you'll be able to hear this. My friends, what you're listening to is the sound of a pair of scissors. This was a tool, again, invented many millennia ago. And it was used to cut hair. All different kinds of people would get their hair cut in all different kinds of ways. Some would never cut their hair and just let it grow long. Others would shave their heads completely. Some would dye their hair different colors. Blue, green, black, blonde, red, blue and green. Blue and black, you name it. And people would pay to get their hair cut at a barber. This barber was someone that specialized in cutting hair. I've been thinking about using this myself, but we'll see. Don't hold your breath. The sound you are listening to now, my friend, and friends, the sound of a leather glove. In case you are not familiar, this is a material made from an animal, skin of a, might have been a cow, dried out, and meant to fit over your hand or hands. And the inside is lined with a soft material. you find this sound to be very relaxing, just like I do. This next item, this next object, is what was once called a corkscrew opener or bottle cap. Difficult to describe. It's partly made of metal, partly made of plastic. It has two arms on either side of a, well, not plastic, but, well, it is all metal. Pardon me. Part of the metal is painted white, like a titanium white. And looks like plastic, but is not. And then it has a metal spiral at the base, which would be inserted into the cork. And these were often used for various glass bottles containing all manners of beverages, where the top of the glass container was stopped with a cork. And you would insert this, screw it into the cork, and then as you did so, these metal arms would rise up as if you were to extend your own arms out and raise them up towards the sky. And then once the screw was fully inserted into the cork, you would push down. man on the arms, and out would pop the cork. Quite a simple yet ingenious device. But I am more intrigued by its sound. And maybe you. Next up, my friend and friends. I have this. Wooden pestle and mortar. Like a wood goblet. Along with a tapered wood handle of sorts. Although not a handle at all, but rather about a 1 inch wide, 6 inch long, was often written about and went by the name of Corvus. Some say he's immortal. But I personally never met that individual. And one of the last things I have for this particular broadcast, my hopefully now well-rested friend and friends, is this old cloth bag of coffee beans. Understand it, again, dates back many millennia to a time known as the Civil War. In a place once known as the United States of America, which of course is partly a wasteland, frozen ice and cold water, of course, due to the poles switching from north and south to east and west. But people would take these coffee beans and grind them up, them into hot water, and they called it coffee. And these coffee beans, they contain an ingredient called caffeine. And this caffeine would provide a temporary boost to one's energy, improve alertness, increase the heart rate a little bit, and the smell of coffee is just out of this world. Very earthy, woody, nutty aroma. that's going to do it for yours truly. It's getting rather late, and I need to get my rest before I go about my business tomorrow. I hope I was able to help you relax, maybe drift off to sleep, but most of all, find some peace of mind. So until next time, whoever you are, wherever you are, however you are, whenever you are, whichever you are, and whyever you are, I wish you nothing but safe journeys as you travel your own path in life. And hopefully, I'll be able to talk to you once again in the not-so-distant future. Take care for now, and so long.